just received word of a devastating explosion at the Marvel National Bank. Over 100 bystanders are reported injured, and currently the death toll is not known. Sources believe that this is the work of the terrorist known as Dr. Mortis. Eyewitnesses have placed Ultra Woman, Marvel's unofficial protector, at the scene shortly before the explosion. Karen Powers, Channel One's on-field reporter, is currently standing by at the scene.
I managed to get word from Ultra Woman just before we went live. She said that everything happened so fast that she couldn't react in time. By her estimate, there were as many as 400 caught in the explosion, including the perpetrator, Dr. Mortis. I'm now receiving word that Councilwoman Linda Holloway is standing by for comments on this horrible tragedy.
I feared this day would come. From the moment Ultra Woman showed her face, this so-called bureau has brought nothing but madness to our city at the cost of our taxpayers' money and now our lives.
But Councilwoman Holloway, perhaps Ultra Woman was only trying to help?
Help? By letting innocent people die? This is all her fault. Do you hear that, Ultra Woman? Just leave our city alone!
Have taken me. long after that day that Ultra Woman was never seen again. Of course, since that fateful day, our mayor, Linda Holloway, ordered that a new building be erected. And with the generous donation of Antonio Vello, we now have the Marville City Memorial Tower, the tourist attraction dedicated to the lives that were lost. Now, some people believe that Ultra Woman was as much of a menace as the criminal she tried to stop. However, others believe that Ultra Woman was a savior who brought hope to those that depended on her protection. So what do you believe?
Right.
Your assignment is to create a video report and discuss whether you are in favor of or against the idea of what a superhero is all about. Have it ready to present in 2 weeks. All right, any questions? Yes, Mr. Ferris.
So is there anything in particular that you'll be looking for?
Actually, I'm gonna give you all creative liberty on this one. Just as long as you present a good case as to what you believe is right.
Does that mean we can film some boobs?
The answer is the same as the last time that you asked. No! Alright, anybody else? Oh, Mr. Schuster, if this is another question about boobs, I swear that I will personally make sure that you...
What will you do?
Ms. Jenkins.
Professor, since we're trying to formulate our opinions about this, what are your thoughts on Ultra Woman?
Well, I personally thought that Ultra Woman was good for our city. But that does not mean that a hero cannot disappoint us. After all, at the end of the day, they're flawed just like the rest of us. All right, I think that's about all for today. Remember, the project is due in 2 weeks.
Well, I think that we should work together on this project.
I mean, with my directing abilities, your camera work, and your...
Maybe not your kind of cheap, but I won't hold it against you. Hey, what do you have there?
Victoria Bella is throwing a party for me.
Hey, a party? Maybe we'll get an invite.
Yeah, what she said about geeks. Can we think about this project now?
I could use some added partying.
Is that all you two can think about?
Yes.
People only like her for her dad's money.
Don't be hating. Her dad does a lot for this Lincoln City. Look, why don't you just go over there and ask her if we can go?
Stupid. Jason!
Alright.
Hi, Victoria. Hi. So I heard you're having a party, and I was wondering if maybe we could
get... What is this, some kind of joke?
Nah, man, this is a joke. What do you call a cow with no legs? Ground beef. What do you call a cow with 3 legs? Lean beef. What do you call a cow with 2 legs? Your mom!
Alright, alright, alright. That's enough.
What's your name?
Jason Ferris.
Whatever. The party's open to everybody, so if you want to bring your friend and girlfriend, I don't care.
Oh, no, she's not my girlfriend.
Whatever. It's BYOB. Our dad's nice enough to let us use his penthouse, but messed up to us. Maybe I'll see you there, Joseph.
Oh, it's Jason. See you there. You see that?
We're invited!
Yeah, real
food,
bro.
Yeah, can we maybe just think about this project, please?
Okay, let's do this.
Right.
Do you really think I was that smooth?
make it like a news story, and we can interview people who are in favor of Ultra Woman during her time here. You can have the lead on this one. You have such great presence.
I don't know, Mal. This kind of sounds like the last project that we did.
Yeah, it's lame.
Do you have a better idea?
I got it. So we have to do this in favor of a superhero, right? So let's show the people what a superhero can do.
What do you mean?
Let's make a superhero.
That's not actually a bad idea.
Just think about it, guys. Jason can be our hero, Faculty, our damsel in distress, and then we can go
you
ahead
want
and
me to be what now?
Fine. Listen, we just need a badass costume and a name.
I have my black skin suit from last Halloween. Maybe we could use that.
I said badass.
No, it could work. We would just need to make some adjustments. Maybe add some blue?
Yeah, blue. What would we call this?
Good question.
My ticket to bigger things.
Me too,
right? Yeah.
I've always had the hope that on the day I go to heaven, Heavenly Father will shake my hand and say, "You've done an awesome job, Quentin. Now it's our time to go out, make a badass movie. And we can do it together, you and me, but mostly me."
Wait, what?
Mostly who now?
You and me, but mostly me, are gonna change the world forever. 'Cause I can do most anything,
and I can stand next to you and watch.
Exactly. Every hero needs a sidekick. Every captain needs a mate. Dinner needs a side dish
on a slightly smaller plate.
And now we're seeing eye to eye. It's so great we can agree. Professor Kane has chosen you and me, but mostly me. Something incredible. I'll do something incredible. I wanna be the person that changed all of mankind.
My best friend.
Something I've foreseen. Now that I'm 19, I'll do something incredible that blows God's great new world. About to change for you, and life is about to change for me, and life is about to change for you and me, but me mostly. And there's no limit to what we can do, me and you, but mostly me.
Okay.
great job with this.
Yeah, it almost looks real.
Okay, well, I think I'm gonna head back to my place. I'll see you tomorrow.
Yeah, see ya.
Wait, is there something?
What's that?
Maybe it would be nice if there really was a PJ that watched over the city, protecting the people and stuff. Maybe if I was that superhero, people would respect me. So, I'll see you tomorrow, man.
Yeah, see ya. Blue Jay was real. Maybe he can be. Upload to YouTube.
Ask and you shall receive.
Jeez, boss, I don't want anyone to hit me like that.
Pick her up. Now let's talk about this Blue Jay character the dudes are just talking about. As you well know, I have top villain over this city. But it didn't happen overnight. I had to scratch and claw my way to the top. And do you know how I did it? I did it by playing my cards right. The city sees me as a philanthropist and a shrewd businessman who looks out for Marvel City. And I do indeed look out for Marvel City. I look out for my stake in this town. And I make sure I hold all of them damn winner cards. I tell you this because of something that happened long ago. The city used to be owned by a man named Dominique Zuko, my former employer. He thought he had the best hand in town until Ultra Woman came along. She was a wild card. And a wild card is unpredictable. Do you know what that makes this Blue Jay?
I don't know, boss.
That makes him a damn wild card, you idiots. Bad enough, the mayor has already pushed the police to shut down as much of my operation as possible. It's only a matter of time before somebody talks. And I cannot afford for that to happen. This Blue Jay and Mayor Holloway problem must be dealt with immediately. I never. Say so. Go now! Idiots. Let's just hope it won't be as big of a problem as Ultra Woman was.
Quit! You're talking about Jason, right?
No.
Yes.
What did you do this time?
It doesn't matter anyway. Why do I even bother with him?
Because you love
him. Yeah, like that matters so much. I've been here right in front of his face the whole time, and he's never going to see me the way that I see him. It's like I might as well not even be there.
Yes, I am the Blue Jay.
I saw the video of you earlier today. You're amazing.
I know.
What?
I mean about the video.
Right. So who are you anyway?
Guys, I think I heard something down this way. Oh my gosh, guys! It's real! It's really real!
Yes, I am the Blue Jay!
Wow, I can't believe this is really real!
Do you have any powers?
Guys, give him some room so I can talk to him.
Thank you, kind citizen.
My name is Stan. Stan Kirby. And I just wanted to let you know that I, along with many other people of this city, think you are the bomb!
You're awesome, Blue Jay!
I think you guys are all great, too! But if you wouldn't mind, I was kind of in the middle of something. Did anyone see where that lady I saved went off to?
I think she went off that way.
Okay. Well, thank you for all your kind words, and be safe!
Hey, I asked if you had any powers!
Wow! I love the I can't believe we just met a real life superhero!
One man fighting crime? I wish we could do something like that.
Hey! Maybe we can't. Just hear me out, guys. One man alone can't take out all of them.
No,
that
can't.
Guys, you're missing the point here. Listen, what if we were to join the Blue Jays fighting crew? We could pull together all our resources to help clean up this city. And maybe if we do a good enough job, the Blue Jay would want to show us how to be the best team of heroes Monville City has ever seen. We just have to find as many people as we can who feel the same way as we do. We can accomplish anything.
You have got to be kidding me. That is the stupidest fucking thing I've ever heard.
What's this? You're giving up so soon? You gotta have a little gumption.
Yeah!
And you kind of attitude. Take it from a guy who knows.
Look at me. You see this face? In terms of beauty, I'm a basket case. As for silence at my fair, well, I guess there ain't a whole lot there.
Yep, although perhaps.
Positivity.
I got positivity.
Dickens says the Sandman, Sal, and the Adelottle. That's why I walk with a wiggle in my waddle. Cause once you heard that word, there ain't nothing you can't do. So let that positivity work for you.
You do realize that's not a fucking word, right?
Of course it is. It's in the dictionary, right between popsicle and prehysterical. Believe you me, I've seen it work miracles.
She's a schmo.
She's a
schlep. Yep. And this one doesn't got the sharpest rep. In fact, all three without a doubt missed the day that brains were handed out.
But if he's no sage and she's no whiz, the whole world thinks that we are geniuses. Cause all our screws may be unscrewed, but take our attitude.
We got positricity.
How about you, huh?
We got positivity.
Let's try it out.
It gives us the beat
and the bang
and the yippee dip.
That's why we sound like the college in our noodle. Cause once you heard that word, there ain't nothing you can't do. So let that positricity.
No. Positrucity.
Positrucity work for you.
Guys, seriously, stop listening to bird brains over here.
Bird brains? Who you calling bird brains? We got natural talent, what I like to call gull ability.
So if the bip and the bap and the blah blah boo, you can slip any flap till your wish comes true. The tip is to tap into something that you believe. With the zing and the zug and the zuzzery, there ain't nothing you can't be. You see, it's really your prerogative. You simply can't be negative.
And there's you just sitting there, smack down flat upon your derriere. If that's the way you wanna be, well, you might as well be strawberry.
Stand right up and dust your seat. Walk real tall upon your own two feet. And sure, you'll trip and make mistakes, but you got what it takes.
You guys see this too, right? I really don't understand right now. Did you guys miss the fact that there was a muggy mess that placed like literally 10 minutes on the ground? This really doesn't seem fair. Question, what would you have done if there were only 5 of you? This isn't high school musical. Guys, seriously, what the fuck? Have you seen this right now?
Bust another one of the mob's dirty money laundering operations. By the time we got there, all that was left was a bunch of goons sitting around using recycled shoe leather to make whips, flails, cattails, and other equipment of BDSM nature. Turns out, sex sells in Marvel City. Rough sex. You can find all the information on the people in this file.
Get any information about these sex people?
Yes. After some interrogation, which they seemed to enjoy, the first guy, Max Toomey, gave us some names. You can find them in the file. The second guy was less useful, but he did tell us that they are working for a man named Boss Tony.
That's some good work, guys. Won't be long before we figure out who this Boss Tony character really is. When we do, I personally want to see the son of a bitch go down. And speaking of SOBs, let's talk about this masked character going around pretending it's Halloween. What information do we have on this clown?
Well, not much of anything, really. Except we did receive an eyewitness report today saying that a man fitting his description was seen on an alleyway near Clark and Kent Street.
That is just super.
Good one, Mayor.
Mayor, a lot of people think these people are only trying to help.
They are vigilantes. They're heroes. They are outlaws. All right, from now on, you have two top priorities. Two. You got that, officer?
How can you have two top priorities now?
Just listen up, and maybe you'll find out, Giggles.
Yes, ma'am.
Shut down Boss Tony's sex operation and do not get involved. And find this, what? Too late. I really need to hire a new help around here. Anyone else wants to step forward? Good. And find this
Blue Jay character, and not a word
about any of the rest of us.
And, you know what, I'll put a third one in, just for giggles here. Put these people behind bars!
Yes, ma'am.
Understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Go to her.
that look in your eyes. I can see in your face that your feelings are driving you wild. Oh, before you're only a child.
But well, I can dance with you, honey, if all the knowledge you're out. And I can chat with you, baby.
Try to slow down, boy. There's no way to go. Does your mother know? Take it easy. Take it easy. Try to cool down, girl. Take it nice and slow. Does your mother know? Wrong girl. This is not that big of a room. She is literally right there.
I can see what you want, but you seem
pretty young to be searching for that.
So maybe I'm not the one.
Did they hurt you?
What? What are you talking about?
Those muggers. The ones the blue jay saved you from?
How do you know about that? You? You're the blue jay?
So, what do you think?
Just a second.
It didn't work.
What?
Your advice! It didn't work!
What are you talking about?
Here, take this.
What's this?
You can hit that address in 15 minutes. Oh, I see what's coming.
No, what was that about my advice not working?
I can't believe it.
Neither can I. That never works for me. Well, what are you waiting for, pal? Go! Go! She wants the D! Mallory, what you doing here? I thought you weren't coming.
Get yourself together. Where's Jason? I need to find him before he goes and says something stupid to Victoria.
Oh, you just missed him. Him and Victoria just went out to have their own personal party, if you know what I mean.
Where did they go?
Oh, find him.
Oh, wait. I do.
This address is in the ghetto. Why would they go there? Why would they go there? You obviously don't know anything, but okay, come on, we're gonna go save him before he gets himself killed.
What? No, if you're gonna go cockblock Jason, you're doing it on your own. I want no part of it!
So be it. Go on, Quentin. You're drunk.
Damn straight I am.
and I like what I hear, what I see, and knowing me, I would be good for you too.
I'm not talking of a hurry night, frantic tones and a shy goodbye.
Marville City used to be watched over by a protector. This protector would shut down all criminal activity and make men like me suffer for just trying to make a buck. That is until this god among men, of those under protection, burned for foolishness. Ever since that day, I've made it my life's work to become the big dog in this town. Let me tell you, I've been making money hand over fist. I used my newfound wealth to give back to the city as a front. Enlightenment was great. That is when some people like you and Mayor Holloway showed up and tried to throw a wrench into my machine.
What did I ever do?
You killed some of my men. That cost me money. Now what in earth shall I do?
Tell him, Daddy.
First I'm going to kill him. Then I'm going to kill Mayor Holloway and any of those idiot cops that have done everything they could to get to me. Once the city has lost its honorable mayor, I will use my influence and power to obtain the position for myself. And there is nobody, there is nothing in all of Marvel City that could stop me.
Well, I just think this is all
going to say bye-bye, Birdie.
Hey! That's the Blue Jay! Quick, somebody get him free!
Alright, Bob?
What do you think? Oh, that was awfully brave of you to try to take out Bob all by himself.
Understand? Oh, good. We got mosey along before the cops show up. Wait, who are you people?
Pardon us. I'm the gamer, and this is martial law.
Howdy, FBJ. For the rest of us...
We're men. We're men at heist. We roam around the forest looking for mice. We're men. We're men at heist. We rob from the rich and give to the poor. That's right! We may look like sissies, but what should you say or else you'll put out your lights? We're men in tights, always on guard defending the people's rights. La 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 la. We're men in tights.
Yes.
Roam around the forest looking for bites. We're men in tights. We rob from the rich and give to the poor. That's right. We may look like pansies, but don't get us wrong or else we'll put out your lights. We're men in tights.
Hey,
tights. Always on guard defending the people's rights.
Yeah, we do. Kind of built into it. Oh!
Yeah, yeah.
Oh! Not cool! We don't get down with no power.
smelly cat, Madam Sheep, and Aaron. We're here in the stew, and it is so awesome to meet you.
I am not Quentin.
What kind of name is Mr. Me?
What kind of name is the EJ?
Hello. Guys, I think we should go before the police get here.
Yeah, game is right.
Guys, let's mosey along.
Is that really necessary?
Can we look?
You should call me sometime.
Okay.
Trying to get as much information as we can out of these people.
This is unbelievable. Tying up doesn't surprise
me. Mayor, we got one of them to talk.
Well, on with it now.
They were attacked by a group of people in costumes.
More costumes.
It would appear so, but that's not all. They also said they are working for a man named Tony Bello.
As in Antonio Bello.
That's what I just said. Lastly, they said that their plan was to kill the Blue Jay, and then kill you, and take over the city. So much for why. But the group of people in costumes, I guess the superheroes help.
What was that word you used again, officer?
Superheroes?
Do not call them superheroes!
Mayor, please. Excuse my tone. I know you hate these people for what they did years ago and how many people they caused to die. But they just took down the mob. They saved my life and yours. And I think we should look to the sky for their inspiration.
You got a sweet looking head, Recipo. A sweet looking head. But you keep it up there in the clouds day after day after day, and you gotta bring it down from there. Do you hear me? Get that head out of the clouds, Recipo! You pull it out of your ass!
Off in the distance, there's a beautiful horizon. Gleaming and radiant, it's what I'll keep my eyes on.
As the world turns to face the sun, start another day. It suddenly occurs to me that maybe we can find another way. Look at the sky, full of hope and promise. It's a shining ideal, how I reel when I look at the sky. Daily they make them pay their nickels, dimes, and quarters. Daily they break them, cause they have to follow orders.
And they keep filling money bags of broken lives and dreams. What's it for? They can more, it's black and more, and profit making schemes.
Look at the sky, high above this madness. Here below, feel our shame, it must stop in the name of the sky.
You guys, we are the law.
What if there's a new law in town that you can catch up? The law didn't come from any potent process, or elected body, or process of judicial review.
That sounds good.
A brand new law that came from an organ.
What?
That's right. A muscular, blood-pumping organ.
What?
Like this one. Right here.
A muscular organ.
Yes. Can you see it, Chief Ketchum?
No.
Well, if this one's too small for you, why not try this one off a size?
Where? It's blinding.
Of course it is.
What? Look at the sky. There's a great big heart.
Wait,
there.
What?
There's a heart
there?
In the sky.
Right?
There just is. Don't spy. It's the sky.
But guys, we're
going to
regret this.
Oh, I don't think so. Come on,
y'all.
This one's on that house.
Wherever
everyone forever!
Hooray!
Your heart knows all things great and true.
What things mere brains can never know.
Your heart points to the great big world. The only
Jesus. Tell me where!
At the sky!
Look at the sky!
Yes, ma'am.
He has a speech impediment.
Why is there a question about what my gender is, officer?
Gather as many men as possible, we grab all the firearms, and go hunt down those freaks and make them leave.
So this is the master plan of the most brilliant criminal overlord in all of Morville City?
Who said that?
You were easily defeated by a bunch of amateurs. What makes you think that you could ever bring anybody down?
Show yourself. I'll show you firsthand what I'll do to those freaks.
I highly doubt that is true, Antonio Bello. Or would you prefer to be called Boss Tony?
Who are you?
My name is unimportant, but if you insist on knowing it, then you may refer to me as Dr. Mortis.
Mortis? No, that can't be true. You're dead.
I stand before you.
Maybe not for long. What do you want?
I want your money, your resources, and your cooperation. You work for me now.
You dumb bitch. You think you can come in here and tell me what to do? Do you know who I am?
Final offer. Fall in line, or just fall.
I think it's time for you to die. Again.
Well, I have died once already, Mr. Bello. Perhaps you should try it.
Ah!
Ah! Very liberating. The offer still stands. You can follow me, or you can follow him. Make your choice.